What if we have been led to believe that our Generation Y is lazy, self-involved, sheltered human beings who can't function without the use of a computer or a smartphone? What if I told you that today's Generation Y is actually a lot more than we've been led to believe? That they are transforming our modern workforces, bringing new ideas, innovation, and energy. Generation Y can be your most creative, motivational, and loyal employees, and are helping lead some of today's largest corporations. Don't believe me? Check this out. I'm Justin Fox, and this is Our Why.
I am a millennial that is passionate about technology, entrepreneurship, and social media, and putting YQG Windsor on the map. I'm the president and CEO of WeTech Alliance, and I'm also an instructor at St. Clair College's Mediaplex. So I went to the University of Windsor. I did business. It was kind of a very broad thing. I knew I liked it. I didn't know what capacity. And it was a Friday, and I was the end of my job, basically. And I had already planned in advance a trip to Montreal to go snowboarding. And I'm thinking, oh my God, Monday, you know, I'm going to have no job. I'm going to be unemployed. So ironically, I get a call on this bus saying, we came across your resume. We have this opportunity for 2 months. And of course, I jumped on it. And that Monday, I started my role at Softech, which is now WeTech.
And I think a lot of even graduates, you know, at the university and the college, that's their biggest fear is, you know, leaving school and not having that employment. Yeah. I can definitely feel that fear and anxiousness that some people share.
The reason why I like telling this story is about networking and the importance of building relationships. So I built a lot of relationships prior to being at WeTech now, and those relationships led me to this. So you never can underestimate who you know. I mean, it's great to know lots and go and get a great education, but you cannot undervalue personal relationships.
You know, it's not just your networking nights and, you know, meeting face to face. You know, explain to me why you think social media is so kind of hands-on nowadays and very important when it comes to networking.
For sure. So social media, and I tell this a lot too when I'm in speaking and with my students, is it's about personal branding. There's a great quote called, if you're not a brand, you're a commodity. And nowadays, your personal brand is extremely important because employers are searching you online. And let's be honest, the eyeballs that you can bring to your social media accounts weigh heavily when you're looking for a job, especially in a marketing-dominant field. If you have a great following and a great brand, it's easier to sell yourself. Because again, we're always going back to those social media platforms, we're Googling people, and really, what we see, we're basically observing a person and making a brand out of them. So social media is a great way to build your personal brand, and it's a great way to connect with employers, with mentors, with other businesses, not just locally, but globally. So it's opened up the opportunities to build your Rolodex and your knowledge that much more broadly and more quickly.
Absolutely. And I always say experience is the new education, right? A diploma, a degree, it's not going to get you those jobs that it might have 10, 20 years ago. You know, what is it like being the first youngest female to run an innovative center in Ontario?
At the end of the day, being the youngest person in this innovation network allows me to leverage all the other leaders in this network. So the Regional Innovation Center Network, there's 17 others across Ontario, and it is a world-class network. So the best part of being in this role so young is that I get to feed off of all the other entrepreneurs, executive directors, and people in this network to not only help myself professionally develop, but to bring back to our community and help their entrepreneurs here.
You know, you talk about, you know, being the youngest one in that role, and I know a lot of frustration, especially with the Generation Y and the millennials, that, you know, we don't get taken serious enough when we're in these roles. If you could give some advice, I guess, to, you know, the younger generation and the millennials moving forward, what kind of advice would you give them?
I mean, I think I go back to, you know, networking and volunteering. I did so much volunteering and like leading up to my career, and it led me to some great connections. And who sits on the board of all these volunteer organizations? They are the who's who of our community.
Absolutely.
Or of your community. So it's important to do that and work hard. I mean, a good work ethic is extremely important. And you want to be, again, the person when they know when they're handing you a project that you're going to deliver that project. So meet as many people as you can. Always professionally develop. Again, education only gets you so far. You have to constantly learn because technology, innovation, education, it's constantly changing. And we need to take it upon ourselves to continue to learn and develop our own self.
Now, so explain some of the highlights in your career. What are, some things that you're most proud of, being in Windsor, Essex County, working in the Innovation Center with WeTech Alliance. Tell me some of your top highlights.
I think first off, and speaking that we're part of this Generation Y conversation is, when I first started my career, I felt really lonely. A lot of my friends left the city, and I just always felt like I was the only young entrepreneur out there, a young professional out there. And so we embarked, a group of us embarked on putting a proposal together for the Ontario Trillium Foundation, and that's what sparked Why Not Windsor Essex, which is a two-year project that helped with youth retention and attraction. And we actually got a call from Premier Wynne to come down to announce that grant. So that was a good indication that we were doing the right thing. And from that led to a moment that I'll never forget. It was, we did a Windsor 180 Summit, and our goal was 250 millennials to attend this event to talk about changing Windsor. So that Windsor 180 movement, and people said, that's never gonna happen. And we're like, no, we're gonna do it. The moment we got that sold out sign on our social media accounts was a moment I'll never forget. And walking into that room and seeing 250 people from Windsor whose bosses were not telling them to be there, who wanted to be there to make change and to meet other like-minded people, it was a moment that just, it brings almost tears to my eyes, because it was just exactly what we've been pushing for. And now you see young people and they're wearing our YQG brand on their hats, on their shirt. There's civic pride.
Absolutely.
That didn't exist 7 years ago. So that is a huge milestone in my career, is seeing, there being young professional awards now that the Chamber's presenting, and BizX
Which
Magazine.
Which you played a role in bringing back, yes.
Yeah, so in BizX, putting together Millennial Blog, and it all started with an idea, and that's the biggest thing I love about Windsor, is the ability to have an idea, a seed, and be able to grow it quickly. You can't do that in larger cities, and you can make an impact very quickly here, and that's one of the reasons why I stay.
I think it shows that Windsor's not that bad place to be. You know, you talked about the hashtag YQG and how you kind of co-started that. Explain that, because, that's everywhere now. Like you said, t-shirts, hats, and people are wearing that with pride.
So I can't take full credit. There is a group that WeTech spearheads called the Social Media Superheroes. And one of the things we said is, we don't have a regional hashtag. So how can you aggregate, curate content about our city if you don't have a hashtag? So we looked at other cities, and the airport code seemed to work. And luckily, ours actually stands for something very ironic and unique, is your quick gateway, which Windsor is to Canada, to the U.S., to a great place to live, work, and play. So we started it. You've got, some key social media users using it. And next thing a year or two later, we're wearing it. Every media outlet's using it, and it's a great way to see what's going on in our community, not just from people living within it, but people visiting.
And I think you mentioned how, a lot of your friends and a lot of the youth are leaving Windsor because they feel there's nothing there. I think this is helping to get them back here, right? Because they're realizing that there is an opportunity to have a life, start a business, and grow within Windsor. Tell us a little bit about your teaching experience, as well as what the Genesis Center has done for our community.
So teaching's been a great experience. I'm at the Mediaplex in the journalism and PR program. So just a great way to, teach other students kind of some of the life lessons that I learned. And again, it's just great to be around youthful people and people early in their careers, because you really hope you can impact them. And this Genesis Center, this is a new space that was recently delivered through the Ontario Centers of Excellence. And this facility is quite unique, right? We need to build that pipeline of entrepreneurs. So, yes, you want to start at the high schools, but to have this at the college is a great asset. So whether you're thinking about entrepreneurship, you just want to become entrepreneurial minded, this center acts as that kind of that center, that hub, that spoke to help build out an entrepreneurial community here on campus. So if you haven't visited the Genesis Center, I definitely suggest you do. They've got great programming and clubs all about that entrepreneurial element. And again, it's not just about being an entrepreneur. It's a skill that a lot of employers look for, is intrapreneurship, that entrepreneurial spirit. Are you able to see solutions to problems? Are you able to think outside the box? And those are the things that the Genesis Center is teaching.
Absolutely. I think it's a great thing for St. Clair College and for the community as a whole, because, being a business grad of St. Clair myself, we didn't really have that outlet. It was more of, you wanted to be an accountant, you're doing this. You want to be an HR professional, you're going to do this. So the fact that now we have this center here where we could think outside the box and see, maybe it's not just that office job. There's things that you could bring your ideas and do something that you love for the rest of your life. And I think it's huge for St. Clair, not only, but for the community as a whole as well.
A lot of people don't realize, but over 90% of the jobs created in Canada are built from small businesses. Mm-hmm. So you think of all the programs that you have at the college, from fashion design to landscaping, they all lend so well into entrepreneurship. So again, this is such an asset to the college, and I'm just thrilled that leadership and the staff here have embraced it, and I just look forward to seeing what comes out of it.
So you had some great advice for our millennials and the Generation Y. Now, what kind of advice would you have for the other side?
I think mentorship is a big one. If you're a Generation X or whatever generation you are, be a mentor. You know, we can learn a lot from the other generation. Also, if you're running an organization or you're on a board, look around the room. Are there people under the age of 40, 30 on your board or committees? Put youth at the table. We should have a voice. Maybe stepping back and letting a young person shine, because at the end of the day, we will be leading, or we are leading this community. And a lot of us, we just want that chance.
Yes. And give them that opportunity. And it's not a failure, right? If they do fail, it's more of a learning experience for them.
You never fail, you always learn.
Well, thanks, Yvonne, for coming today and sharing your story with us. And thanks again for being a role model to the millennials and the Generation Y in our community.
Thank you.